Looking to create repeatable processes that require mathematical operations or complex logic? You can add advanced formula steps to your SAP Analytics Cloud data actions that enable you to construct your own formulas. Most step types, copy, cross-model copy, allocation, and currency conversion steps, have predefined settings that guide you in performing common tasks. However, if you want to go beyond the capabilities coded into these types of data action steps by applying mathematical operations or setting up complex logic, such as multiplying values by a growth factor when you copy them from actuals to plan, you can add advanced formula steps to your data actions. When constructing your formulas, you can choose the visual tool, which enables you to build the formula by defining the underlying business logic, or the script tool, where you can directly write the script. The visual tool is designed to support users with no expertise in programming. It's not intended to replace manual scripting for very complex scenarios. However, there is significant overlap between what you can accomplish in the two environments. When working in the visual tool, the first step is to define the scope or context of the action, if necessary. By default, calculations are performed on all combinations of measures and leaf members for all dimensions in the selected model. Limiting the scope of a calculation ensures that the results match your expectations and helps to improve performance. Here, you'll limit the scope of the calculation to apply only to the gross revenue account, and only to values from the desired period. You can choose a fixed period or use a parameter to enable the period to be selected when the data action is run. Here, parameters for the from and to dates have already been defined. Details on how to set up parameters are available in the How to Plan Using Basic Steps in Data Actions video. Next, you can optionally define variables to use in your formula, which act as placeholders to pass other values into the calculation. Variable types include float, which are decimals, integer, which are whole numbers, and variable member, which are dimension members. In the begin token, you can also set configuration options for the formula, for whether to use the fiscal year settings, calculate values as positive or negative based on account type, or treat unbooked data as zero values. Once these foundational elements are in place, you can start constructing your calculation. The visual tool enables you to click to select and click and drag to reorganize the elements of the formula. Several types of statements are available: calculation, repeat, condition, delete, and comment. The calculation statement lets you define where you want the results of the calculation to be copied, and then to specify where the values on which the calculation is based will come from. The repeat statement enables you to repeat another statement for each member of a selected dimension. The condition statement allows you to add if-then logic to your formula to make the execution of an operation conditional on some other factor, such as whether a value is greater than or less than another value. The delete statement lets you delete all or a portion of the data in the defined scope for the calculation. And the comment statement lets you add comments to your formula so that you can keep track of your intentions for each section. To set up a formula that multiplies values by a growth factor when they are copied from actuals to plan, you'll need a calculation statement. By default, the scope of the target is defined as all combinations of dimension members, accounts, and time periods within the specified model, limited by any filters applied in the context. You can further limit the scope if required, such as specifying the month into which values will be copied using a fixed value or a parameter. On the other side of the equation, you can choose what operations you want to execute to generate the target data. That can be a combination of source scope, a function that looks up values from other dimensions and measures from this or other models, common mathematical expressions, and input fields, which enable you to specify a numeric value. In this case, you need to define the source scope as the values from the actuals version, and then multiply those values by a value of 1 plus a growth factor. If you want to be able to change that growth factor when the data action is run, you can create a numeric parameter instead of setting a fixed value. Keep in mind that a percentage must be entered as the equivalent decimal. Here, multiplying a value by 0.1 will give you 10%. You can then use this parameter to enter the value into the input field at runtime. To finish the expression, you need to enclose the addition in parentheses, so that operation happens first, and then change the operator to multiply the source values by this final value. Once you save your changes, the data action is complete and ready to run. If you switch to the script tool, you can see the script generated from the elements you've put together with the visual tool. Alternatively, you can construct the same script directly. A basic script already populates the tool with comments that explain the different elements. You can remove the tags at the beginning and end of the script to change this from a multi-line comment, and then delete or modify any of the predefined statements as needed. When you start typing, the script tool prompts you with the available values that match your entries. The same filters that you use to define the scope of the target and source can be rendered here using the relevant dimensions and measures, which start with a square bracket, parameters, which start with a percentage sign, and members, which are signified with double quotation marks. As you construct the statement, you can hover the cursor over the elements to see the scope, which can help you to optimize the performance of the data action. You can also add any mathematical operations with operators and numbers or parameters. Once the script is constructed, you can validate it to check your syntax. Tools are also available here to correct the formatting, comment out parts of your formula, show or hide different helper features, and search within your formula for specific values. The completed data action can now be incorporated into other data actions as an embedded data action step, added to multi-actions, or run directly in stories, which are all covered in other videos. For more information on how to add advanced formula steps to your data actions, check out the help topic links in the description and the other videos about data actions, and try it for yourself today.